At this point in our professional online saddle fit assessment process, your Schlaese evaluation form has been filled out to reflect the conversions made from your measurements, as well as all of the additional information you've provided us from your photos and saddle information. After we receive your static photos, your lunging and riding video footage, as well as your measurements, we will be able to start identifying any fit concerns similar to how we do our professional assessment on site. As we are reviewing the footage, we set up a call to discuss any fit concerns or questions you may have in a one-on-one consultation. This is an in-depth consultation where you and your appointed certified saddle ergonomist can discuss in real time your horse's movements and anything that they see in your submitted long-distance fit kit information and measurements. As we are completing our dynamic assessment, we record our comments on how the horse is behaving and on the biomechanics of both horse and rider relevant to saddle fit. This may include things such as rider position, stiffness in movement, and other subtle behaviors that may present themselves in response to various saddle fit factors. We operate under the firm belief that horses do not consciously behave badly. They react to outside stimuli, whether it be a poorly fitting saddle or an unbalanced rider causing these kinds of behaviors. Some of these unwanted behaviors that your horse may be demonstrating could include the following, such as ears pinned back, girthiness, stumbling, tripping, lameness, rearing, bucking, resistance to move forward, or a tight, hollow back. At Schlaese, we take the time to listen a little more to what the horse is trying to tell us. Horses can't speak, but their behavior speaks volumes. To provide you with a more in-depth idea of what to expect during an online dynamic assessment consultation, here is one of our certified saddle ergonomists and their comments on a client-submitted dynamic footage. When assessing dynamic footage, we are especially looking at the horse's eyes, ears, and the tail, as these are often the main tells of discomfort in the horse. These will be the first things that I take a closer look at when assessing the submitted footage. First, I notice right off the bat that the horse is very busy with her tail. She is swishing it, but not in the way that she would to ward off flying insects. This movement of her tail is indicative of distress. In a series of studies over the past few years, Sue Dyson, head of clinical orthopedics at the Animal Health Trust Center for Equine Studies in Newmarket, UK, and colleagues, developed and validated an ethogram for ridden horses. Essentially, it's a catalog of behaviors a horse might display under saddle and what they mean. Clamping of the tail, holding the tail to one side, or consistent tail swishing movements during riding are part of the 24 behaviors the study identified as most closely associated with pain. This particular mare is displaying clamping of the tail, as well as persistent swishing of the tail. We will definitely make a note of this on their Schlaese evaluation form. At one point or another, most riders will encounter a horse that is said to be girthy or cinchy. Typically, girthiness is when a horse displays adverse behaviors such as grinding of the teeth, throwing the head up, and pinning of the ears when the girth is tightened. You can see this very clearly in this video. This horse would be considered girthy. Often, girthiness is thought to be directly connected to the girth, and while that can be the case, it can often be attributed to an ill-fitting saddle. When the girth is tightened, pressure is placed on the billets and the saddle is pulled tighter onto the horse's back. If the saddle is ill-fitting, hitting one of the 14 negative reflex points, the horse will feel this discomfort and possibly pain very clearly when the girth is tightened. Part of our assessment of the fit of the saddle is to ensure that the correct type and length of girth is used. Also, we use this opportunity to rule out girthiness as a result of the girth itself rather than the result of a poorly fitting saddle. Like many of these other behaviors, girthiness can be challenging because even after underlying reasons for the horse's reaction have been ruled out, a horse may continue to display girthy behavior in anticipation of physical or emotional discomfort. In this case, it can take time for the horse to internalize that the anticipated pain will no longer occur. In any case, we urge you to be patient when saddling and girthing a horse to prevent the development of anticipative behaviors, and if it does occur despite your efforts, to rule out possible underlying issues including ill-fitting tack. The goal in riding is to have the horse move over the back, carrying the rider by engaging the muscles of the top line. If, however, the saddle puts pressure on the negative reflex points along the spine, the horse will reflexively lower its back to escape the pressure or pain. You can see here that this horse is hollow behind the saddle, leaving the croup high. Pressure on the negative reflex points along the spine can occur for numerous reasons, such as a gullet channel that is too narrow, or because of a saddle that twists during movement as a result of a horse's natural asymmetry that has not been taken into consideration when fitting the saddle. This can evolve into a very frustrating experience for horse and rider. The horse would like to respond to the rider's aids, but the pressure on the negative reflex points inhibits the horse's ability to do so. This can be compared to your knee reflex. Even if the doctor tells you to try and refrain from kicking, when he taps your patellar tendon, there's nothing you can consciously do to avoid this reflex. Next, I'm going to take a look at the leg movement to see if the horse is tracking up, meaning if the hind limbs at least reach the hoof print of the front limbs. Here, you can see that this particular horse is not quite tracking up and is moving what we would call short. Tracking up or over-tracking indicates the horse is engaging the hind limbs, stepping underneath themselves to round and lift their back. Not tracking up indicates that their ability to do so is inhibited, and checking the fit of the saddle is the first step to improving the horse's ability to track up. Something we often see is head tossing, resulting in inconsistent contact, which is a common sign of discomfort under saddle. Sadly, we see this very frequently when the angle of the tree is too wide and the saddle sits close to the withers, which puts pressure on the spinal nerve within the withers cup, igniting cranial nerve 11, which is extremely painful for the horse. Rivaling horses will dominate each other by biting this wither area. During breeding, the stallion will bite the mare in this area, resulting in a nerve signal to the brain to block movement in the upper arm and shoulder blade, preventing forward movement. Another signal ensures that the longissimus dorsi muscle, directly underneath the saddle, contracts, dropping the horse's back, pulling the head up, and rotates the pelvis forward in preparation for mating. The same effect occurs if a saddle's gullet plate pinches the side of the withers. Sufficient clearance surrounding the withers is crucial to avoid pressure in this area and the resulting tossing of the head and inconsistent contact. Of course, some of these exhibited behaviors can be attributed to factors other than saddle fit, and sometimes, even after the fit of your saddle has been addressed, a horse may continue to display these behaviors in anticipation of the discomfort or pain that they were experiencing. If the behaviors don't subside after a few rides, we always recommend looking into other factors that could elicit the behavioral response you are observing in your horse. Additionally, not every horse will exhibit all of these behaviors, and each consultation is unique to the horse and rider. This one-on-one consultation also provides you the opportunity to discuss how you feel when you ride and to describe any concerns you may have with your horse and their movement. Once we have completed your assessment and the form has been filled out, we will provide you with a detailed copy of the report so that you may track the changes in your horse and keep track of any behaviors your horse has previously exhibited under saddle. If you have any questions, please contact us using the following contact information to be connected with the Schlaese representative.